There are billions of web pages on the internet and hundreds of thousands of new pages added every single day. So how is it possible for search engines to determine what page is important to the user? In this video, we'll explore the process of how search engines are able to deliver the results in a blink of an eye. Let's go! Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress sites, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Now, the thing is, when you do a search on the search engines, you are not actually searching for information in real time. The search engines did not go out there, grab the information from the web, analyze it, and produce the results for you on the spot. The fact is, search engines have a huge database of web pages that they have crawled and stored over the years, and they're still doing it on a daily basis. So when you're searching for something, you're actually getting information from their database. So understanding the process of how search indexing works can help you as a site owner optimize your content to ensure that it gets properly indexed and ranked by the search engines. In general, search engines go through a three-step process: crawling, indexing, and ranking. And there are more to that, we'll talk about it. But for now, let's start with crawling. To build a database of web pages, search engines will send their robots, or seasoned SEOs, we'll call them spiders, to scan web pages and gather information, and that process is called crawling. Google has this list of robot crawlers, Bing has their own list of crawlers, Yandex has their crawlers as well. The same goes for DuckDuckGo, Baidu, and basically any kinds of search engines will have their own web crawlers. When these robots visit a site, they will read the directive of the website called Robots.txt. This document will tell search engines which pages or sections of the website they are permitted to visit and which should be avoided. For example, when you visit rankmath.com on a browser, at the URL you can add /robots.txt. And as you hit enter, you will see the site directive for the search engines. The same goes for WP Rocket, as you can see. The same goes for one.com as well. So almost every website will have a robots.txt directive file to guide web crawlers. As a RankMath user, if your server does not contain a robots.txt file, you can edit the file through RankMath. Go to the general settings, click on edit robots.txt, and here you can adjust your directives for the search engines accordingly. And to know if there are any errors on your robots.txt file, you can use our robots.txt tester and validator too. This is the link. The same link is in the description. You can simply add your domain URL here. You can test the instructions to specific search engine crawlers and hit test. And you will know if there are any errors on the file. As you can see, there is no error with the file. But if I test, for example, this URL, you will see that there is an error here. If you want to quickly solve and validate the error, you can switch it to the editor mode where you can adjust the instructions. Let's validate the changes and the problem is solved. Now, any amendments made here will not reflect the content on the actual robots.txt file. This is just a validator. So whatever amendments you make here, make sure that you copy and paste it on your actual robots.txt file, as we have discussed earlier. If you want to understand more about the language of the robots.txt file, you can check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Now, once the search engine robot is on your site, they will not crawl only one page. As it scans the page and finds a link, it will visit the link to the next page and start crawling. And the process will continue until there is nothing left to crawl on your site. So with this understanding, search engines will naturally crawl all pages of your site as well as pages your site links to. But what if there are pages where there are no internal or external links pointing to them? They are what we call orphan pages, and search engines hardly take notice of them. So as a site owner, if you want your pages, even the orphan pages, to be noticed by the search engines, you should upload an XML sitemap to the search engine's console. As a RankMath user, once you have toggled on the sitemap module, you can find your XML sitemap in the sitemap settings, right here. This is the link to the sitemap index, which is a page that consolidates all the different sitemaps in one place. This is a good SEO practice. And when you go to RankMath's general settings, visit the analytics tab, and you have connected the site to your Google account that manages your search console and analytics, the XML sitemap index will be submitted to Google automatically. For Bing, you will have to visit its webmaster too, sign in with probably the same Google accounts for your convenience, and you can import all the sites from the Google Search Console. Yandex has its own webmaster tools, Naver has its own webmaster tools. Basically, most search engines will provide you with a webmaster tool. And one more thing I want to mention about getting your pages noticed is this. When you toggle on this instant indexing module, without you taking any further actions, search engines like Bing, Yandex, and Zasnum will automatically be notified of any new, updated, or deleted pages on your site. This can help speed up the crawling and indexing process of your site. So if you haven't toggled this module on, you should consider doing so. And if you want Google to immediately take notice of any new, updated, or deleted pages automatically, then you will want to watch this video to get it set up. The link is in the description. Anyway, once the robots have successfully crawled the pages of your site, they will bring it back to Google for processing. Before any content is indexed on a search engine's database, they will be processed, which is part of the indexing stage. This is where the search engines will analyze the content and remove unnecessary elements like JavaScript-heavy components, duplicated content, thin content, pages with many broken internal or external links, excessive advertising or intrusive ads, non-visible elements, flash content, large media files like images or videos without proper optimization, tracking codes and parameters, and anything that does not contribute to search relevance. This is to optimize the search engine resources and only index elements that make a difference to the search results. So for large websites, you'll be familiar with the term crawl budget, where the search engines will limit their resources to crawl the pages of your site. So for huge websites, if your pages are loaded with unnecessary elements, then some of your important pages may not go past the processing stage. So you really have to optimize your pages for page speed and for user experience. You can check out these two videos to help improve them. Now, any pages on your site that are disregarded during the processing stage can be found in your Search Console or Webmaster Tools. As you go to your Search Console, under the indexing category, click on Pages, and here are all the issues and the number of pages that are disregarded during the process. Click on the issue and you will see all the pages that are affected. And if you are a RankMath Pro user, you can discover all the issues directly on your site. On the Analytics module, go to the Index Status tab, and here are all the issues. You can sort the issues accordingly, and these are the pages under the same issue. Click on the page and it will provide you with more details about the indexing status. We have covered many of these indexing issues on separate videos, so feel free to check them out if you're encountering any one of these issues. The links are in the description. Now, once the pages of your site have passed the processing stage, they will go to the final stages of indexing. The thing is, not all pages of your site are prioritized for indexing equally. Search engines like Google will prioritize mobile-friendly content first, so it would be wise to install a mobile-friendly theme if you're running a WordPress site. On top of that, high-quality and original content that offer value to users are more likely to be indexed first before anything else. So if you want to write content that will be prioritized by the search engines, we recommend writing the first draft of any topic with our blog post wizard tool. This tool can write high quality long form content for you in seconds. This is a three-step process. The first step is about generating a blog post idea. Simply add a description of your industry or niche and hit generate. And here you go. But if you already know what topic to target, you can click skip. And the next step is to generate a blog post outline. So let's add the topic here, add your personally researched main points and ideas, or you can have the AI generate them for you. For me, I prefer to keep this field empty so that the AI will generate its own ideas. Then select an audience. There is a long list of predefined audience, but if you can't find a suitable one, you can always customize it. And then the focus keyword will most likely be the same as the topic. Next, select the tone. For the blog post outline, I like to keep it as formal, but when it comes to generating the content, I will change the tone later. For the style, I think this topic calls for a tutorial. This really depends on the topic at hand. And finally, the language. There are 28 languages to choose from and counting, but let's keep it as English. And when we are done, let's hit generate. Give it a while, and we will have a blog post outline. If you think this is not good enough, you can always hit regenerate. But if this is good enough for you, you can change the tone, such as friendly and conversational, and let's hit write post. From here, Content AI will start generating a complete piece of content. Let's give this a while, and we are done. As you can see, we have an FAQ section, a conclusion, and then all the important points, an introduction, and it has generated 1200 words because this topic does not call for a super long post. Yet, this is a comprehensive piece of content. Now, if you're happy with this piece of article, you do not have to copy and paste it into a new post. You can simply click on Create New Post, and a new post that is well formatted will be created. From here, you can fact check, add your knowledge and expertise to the content. Never take this generated content as final. It should only be a first draft. That's how you can create high quality content search engines will prioritize in seconds. On top of quality content, search engines will also employ advanced indexing techniques like the natural language processing models such as BERT or MUM to understand the user intent and index content accordingly. Structured data or schema markups help search engines understand the context of the content as well, because it is the language of the search engines, and they may reward your page with rich snippets, like the star rating and the pros and cons rich snippets. The schema markup to achieve these snippets can be found on your WordPress editor. Go to the Rank Maths tab, visit the schema options, and click on the schema generator. Now, the review rating and the pros and cons schema can be found in the book, course, movie, product, recipe, and the software schema. So you have to apply the appropriate schema. For example, if you are a third party reviewing a SaaS product, such as a Rank Math review, you can use the software schema. Add whatever information to the best of your knowledge. This pros and cons schema is only meant for third-party reviewers, so do not use this to review your own product. And once you have added all the information, click on Save for this post, and the schema will be added to the page. Let's save this post, and to know if the schema information are correctly applied, let's visit the page, copy its page source, then visit the Google's Reach Results Testing tool, select the code option and paste the source code here, and let's test the schema. And as you can see, using Rank Math, you should easily pass the schema test. We have passed the review snippets. If you want to dive deeper and learn more about Rank Math schema features, we recommend that you visit our channel and search for schema, and you will find many videos that will help you out. So making sure that your pages contain high quality information and applying the appropriate schema markups will help search engines sort your content based on the search intent in their database. And once the pages are indexed accordingly, it will go through the final stage, which is the ranking stage. As you may know, there are hundreds of ranking factors, from analyzing the quality of your backlinks to having the main focus keywords in the SEO title to analyzing unique insights. It is a very complex process. So we have talked about the most important ranking factors and what you must do to rank higher in the search engines through this video right here. Feel free to check it out. The link is in the description. Now, there is one more thing about crawling and indexing you should know. The thing is, even though we have a Robots.txt directive that prevents the search engine's robot from crawling a page, that page might still be crawled and indexed if there are other pages on the internet that are linking to it. So to prevent a page from being indexed, the best way is to add a no-index meta tag to it. For example, you want to prevent this page from being indexed. You can go to the Rank Maths tab, and on the Advanced Options, you can set the robot's meta to no-index and save the page. And if you have multiple pages, such as we have this page that talks about BBQ grilling tips, and we have another page that discusses grilling tips for BBQ, they are basically discussing on the same topic. So even though the text and the content may be different, they are considered duplicates in the eyes of the search engines. So search engines will only index one page. It can be this page or this page. And in extreme cases, both pages will not be indexed. So you have to direct search engines and tell them which is the page you want them to index. And if you want, for example, this page to be indexed, you will have to add a canonical tag on the other page, telling the search engines to disregard this page and index this page. So we will have to copy the URL of the page we want to index. Then on the page we want to disregard, you can go to the Rank Maths tab and go to the Advanced Options. And right below, you will see the canonical URL. As you can see, by default, all pages are self-canonicalized. So if we want search engines to disregard this page, we will add the link of the other page, telling the search engines that this is a duplicated page, you want them to index this page instead. I hope this is easy for you to understand. So that's how search engine indexing works and how you can control what pages to be indexed. If you find value in this video, can you do us a favor and smash that thumbs up? And if you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.